Hi Vinash, how are you?
Yeah, I'm fine. How are you?
I am doing great, Vinash. Thanks for asking.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
So my pleasure, Vinash. How your lockdown are going on?
Yeah, but it's okay. Till now, very, very nice. Why? Because we are working from home. Right? We are spending our free time with our family instead of spending free time with our friends and Netflix or Amazon. Right?
The time has been changed. So first you will be spending time with your friends, now with your family. Good.
Yes.
So Avinash, why don't you introduce yourself to our audience?
Yeah. Hello, everyone. My name is Avinash. Basically, I'm from Naswapeta, which is present in Guntur district, Andhra Pradesh. I completed my BTech in computer science department. Currently, I'm working in Rakuten as an intern. And my role is DevOps.
Great, Avinash. Great. So Avinash, currently you will be working as an intern in recruitment company. I think you'll be missing your college days, right? Your college days, your friends, faculty. So any talk on that, your college life, Avinash?
Yeah, exactly. Why? Because college days are memorable days. Like you can't get those days after once completing the college.
Yeah.
Why? Because suppose if your BTech is common for everyone nowadays. After BTech, our friends they started business, some people started working in job, and some people go to higher studies. In BTech, we will meet all kinds of friends. The people with the business ideas, the people who are having higher education plans in future. Yeah, why? Because in BTech only, you have so many experience with our friends and lecturers. So suppose if you take first year, it will be very slow.
Yeah.
After first year, second year, third year, fourth year, you don't know when it will complete.
That's the specialty of engineering, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
So I mean, it's like, I'm since from 2 years, I'm sitting at home and listening to the online classes. Like, I understand your issues, man. Since you are already completed your graduation, so I can understand your issues. And if you're looking into your preparation part, I mean, like at what stage of your academics so you started preparing for this placement thing and all?
Okay, I started HackerRank at the first year, second semester.
Okay, great.
First year, second semester. Basically, it is like a very, very, very basic questions.
Okay.
In HackerRank. That is okay for some companies. You want higher companies or big companies, it is not okay. Like the knowledge which you are gaining from HackerRank is not okay.
Okay.
Basically, I started coding itself. I didn't started any aptitude, reasoning, verbal, not any of this. I didn't even touch also. But yeah. I started coding.
Coding.
After coming to third year, second sem, I realized that you don't need coding. With coding, you need aptitude, verbal, reasoning.
Okay.
And those things also you need along with coding. So I started preparing for my interview.
Okay.
From 3-2 onwards. Not even 3-1 also, 3-2.
Great, great. So Avinash, as you mentioned earlier, you're currently being as a part of Rakuten, you are also giving service to the community, right? So any talk on your company, Avinash, Rakuten company?
Basically, it is like Reliance. Indian Reliance.
Okay.
Basically, in India, that company has many branches. They are in every field.
Okay.
Like that, in Japan, it has in every field. It is not a service base or it is not a product base. It is overall company, I can say.
In every field, they are giving contribution. Like in every
In every sector. Field, they are giving the best contribution. Why? Because recently they are launching a 5G network in Japan.
Okay, great.
Our company, they are getting awards also for 5G technology.
Yeah, I have seen articles regarding that. Yeah.
Yes.
So great, great Avinash. One more Avinash is if possible, just try to briefly explain its hiring process of your company. What are the level of its hiring, and if possible, just try to explain briefly.
Okay. Initially, you are having assessment test where it contains two coding questions and normal aptitude and reasoning questions.
Okay.
after completing, after clearing the first round, you are having two technical rounds. Mm-hmm. Two technical rounds. Okay. One is both are technical, but while in technical round, you have to concentrate on basically data structures and algorithms,
mm-hmm.
and SQL operating system.
Okay.
And if you are coming from CSE background, all the concepts like basic idea, what is cloud, what is machine learning.
The technical knowledge.
Basic technical knowledge is enough. Basically, if I want to stress is, if you are good at data structures and algorithms, yeah, it's totally fine. You can crack any company.
Mm-hmm. So like, as you mentioned earlier, like in recruiting, it has assessment, technical part one, technical part two, and last will be HR. So like,
for me, there is no HR, basically.
Okay.
Only there are two technical rounds.
So like, as you mentioned, like, is the level of difficulty is increases in technical part two, or like your topics are different? What they were going to ask in?
Suppose if I take an example, if I ask someone to write algorithm on MudSort.
Okay, MudSort.
Yeah, what you will do, you will explain the what is MudSort, and okay. you will try to code.
Okay.
Okay, MudSort is based on the divide and conquer, right?
Mm-hmm.
You are dividing. Okay. They will ask, what is that concept also? Like, they need in-depth knowledge about that.
Achha. Got it.
Understood, right?
Yeah,
like, basically, if you write MudSort algorithm, it's okay. If you remember that algorithm, you can write. But while explaining, they will ask so many questions regarding that. What is the time complexity? What is the worst case? What is the best case? What is the space complexity? Everything they will ask.
So they'll be asking related questions to a single concept. Like
yeah, even they don't need code also.
Okay.
They need whether you are good at in conceptual wise or not.
Mm-hmm.
If you are good at in conceptual wise, they mm-hmm. ask it for coding.
So got it, Avinash. So Avinash, so one thing I would like to ask, like it's my personal in the sense, like everybody has this question in there. So what is the role of communication during the interview? Because we students have a mentality that we will prepare only for technical part and nobody gonna give importance to the communication part. So like during interview, I think it plays a very important role. So what is your talk on that?
Yeah. Before going to your question, I have one point. Why? Because nowadays every interview is in online.
Yeah.
There will be effect in future for us also. Why? Because while you want to shift the company, while you want to migrate to company,
okay,
you have to attend the interview in offline mode.
Okay.
Now we are attending our interviews in online mode. There will be so much difference. In online mode, it hardly take 20 or 30 minutes.
Yeah.
But in offline mode, you don't know when it will complete also.
Mm-hmm.
In online mode, communication is a very key role in the interview. Why? Because you know the concept, but you have to convey that concept. Right?
Same thing. I mean, like even I was mentioning same thing in my previous interview with one of my senior. Like he said, you have to feel the interview has a friend. In that mentality, if you have to speak, then we can overcome this nervousness and all.
Yeah, basically, first two interviews will be nervous. After that, okay, in interview, you don't cheat the person. Who is taking interview. Why? Because if you are able to cheat, he will screw you up. Like, he will ask so many questions.
For every reaction, there will be equal and opposite reaction.
Yeah, especially... Especially in interviews, there will be very pressure on you. You have to answer carefully to their questions. Otherwise, you will be screwed up.
Got it, Avinash. So, Avinash, additional to that, what is the role of resume? Resume and as well as what you introduce. So, I thought that, I think that what you give introduction, based upon that only, the interviewer is going to ask the questions.
Yeah.
So, any talk on that, Avinash?
Yeah, basically, resume is like your identity in the interview.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Understood.
Yeah.
Based on your introduction only, they will ask questions
mm-hmm.
by seeing your resume. In the resume, suppose there are different kinds of resumes. Like nowadays, you are applying in online, and even interviews are taking online.
Yeah.
Better to use your photograph in business. By default, so many people not use photographs in
photographic
business. Yeah. My suggestion is that your resume has to be in one page.
Mm-hmm.
The points should be clear cut.
Okay.
Right? If you are done a project, simply mention what is the project that's it.
Okay.
Yeah. And how much time it take for you.
Okay, from starting to end.
Yeah, what are the skills you learned? Like, suppose if you are taking machine learning, I learned Python, I learned NumPy packages. Like.
Mm-hmm.
And one more thing, education part, it is common. They will not ask about the education part.
Yeah.
They will ask about hobbies.
Yeah.
Yeah, it basically depends upon the resume. Even big companies, they will shortlist candidates based on resume. That is the reason many people prefer a resume in one page.
Mm-hmm.
Or freshers especially.
Got it, Avinash. Got it. So Avinash, last but not the least, any suggestions to audience, Avinash?
Yeah, exactly. I am very happy to share suggestions.
We are excited to hear you, Avinash.
Yeah, basically, start your placement from first year onwards.
Okay.
Like not placement, start to build a resume from first year onwards.
Okay, great.
Building resume is different. Writing resume is different.
Mm-hmm.
If you're starting building a resume from first year,
okay,
by the end of the fourth year, at least you will get one internship or two internships. Why? Because in first year, while writing your resume, maybe it will take off base only.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe like that. Yeah. Correct only, right?
Yeah.
Then you will realize that I have to do much more things to get in better company.
Agreed.
And second thing is basics.
Okay.
Basics are a very key foundation for every interview.
Okay.
Even in basics also, if you are good at basics, try to learn data structures and algorithms in detail as much as possible.
Yeah.
While coming to programming languages,
okay,
I am Pythonic guy, like, because I write every program in Python.
Python, yeah.
Yeah, why? Because it is very simple. But while writing in Python, you have to know the concept.
Yeah, manual thing.
Basically, after all those interviews and all my experience, I prefer Java, C++.
We know your Java story, Avinash.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Java is okay, but many companies are using still Java.
Agreed.
Yeah. So that is the reason if you choose Java, it is very helpful for you in future also. Whether you will do on Java or not, but someday it will help for you. Python, very, very big companies are doing in Python.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Because Python runtime is very slow. It will take more time. But Java is okay. Very good. And third one is be confident while attending the interview. Don't be panicked.
This is an important point. Yeah.
Very confident. Like it is not like overconfident. What you know, you due to your interview, like what you know the concepts, whether you, if you know the concept, then tell okay. If you don't know, tell don't know. Okay. If you try to mug up the things, means he will screw up. Guarantee.
Yeah, Avinash. I think I have covered all the questions which are necessary for our audience. And yeah, Avinash, thank you for making time and joining me. And sorry for bothering your weekend. And
yeah, it's okay.
Restoring your weekends. And thanks once again and making time and joining me and giving inputs. I think these inputs are helpful for our audience. And yeah, guys, this is all about our interview experience. And if you have any kind of doubt, you can comment it down. And I will be sharing Avinash's resume so that you can go through it and you can look at it pattern so that you can get a complete idea that what to put into the resume and what not to put into the resume. And he mentioned that make, if possible, make resume too short in the sense like in one page. So instead of putting all unnecessary things, just put what you know in there. And additional to that, as I said, be honest with the interviewer, don't try to cheat. And instead of like being more confident is also not good, low confidence also not good, being confident is, plays a very important role. And yeah, guys, this is all about today's interview. And I think you enjoyed it and make use of this. And thank you, guys. And thank you, Avinash, for making time once again.